You're watching Tag TV.
India is well known around the world owing to its historical background, diverse cultures and interesting traditions. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in the field of science and technology, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay, and today in our episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. India celebrates a number of festivals throughout the year. While some festivals are celebrated with equal pomp and show across the country, others are limited to a particular region only. One such festival is Marbat, which calls triumph of goodness over evil and is celebrated only in India's western Nagpur city of Maharashtra. Thousands of people recently took to the roads of the Nagpur city to celebrate the 130-year-old Kali Marbat festival, where devotees take out a procession of effigies meant to represent evil forces and eventually burn them. Held a day after the Bullock Festival of Pola that started in 1880 in the eastern part of the city, the main motive behind celebrating Kali Marbat Festival is to safeguard the city from the attack of vicious evil spirits. Dressed in traditional attires, thousands of devotees took part in the procession, carrying marbats or clay effigies of Kali, meaning black, and pibli, meaning yellow. While the Kali Marbat represents Bhosla Queen Banka Bai, who surrendered to British power, the Pibli Marbat, which originally symbolized atrocities of the British rulers, today stands for the social evils like corruption and epidemics.
जब देश गुलामी की जंजीरों में जकड़ा हुआ था तब यहाँ पर जो स्वतंत्रता के लिए जो आंदोलन हुआ था उसमें भोसले राजा के काल में एक बकाबाई थी जिसने अंग्रेजों के साथ हाथ मिला लिया था उसका कहीं कहीं विरोध करने के लिए काली मारबत को स्थापित यहाँ पर किया गया और काली मारबत को घुमाया जाता है लेकिन आज जो समय जैसे बीता गया वो एक उत्सव के रूप में आज मनाया जाता है यहाँ पर
Though the festival is predominantly organized by the Teli and Koshti, the traditional oil traders and weavers communities, others too participate in it with same zest and ardor. The Marbat festival is being celebrated for more than a century now, and with time, the significance of the festival has also changed completely. Before India gained independence, the festival was primarily a way to arouse feelings of patriotism among people. But today, people celebrate this festival to draw the government's attention towards various social issues such as terrorism, natural calamity, diseases, and several others. A number of badgayas, meaning mascots, representing contemporary symbols of evil, comprise another feature of the annual procession. A lot of people also believe that Pibli Marbat will make their wishes come true during this festival.
माता मानते सब देवी मानते सब मन्नतें मांगते पूजा करते हैं या पांच दिन पूजा चलती है रात भर पूरी भीड़ रहती है लोग ओटी भरते हैं मन्नतें मांगते हैं और उनकी मन्नतें पूरी होती है और हर साल इसकी आस्था बढ़ते जा रही है।
The Marbat, therefore, gives vent to people's frustrations and acts as a means of protest, albeit with an element of light-hearted fun. Jammu and Kashmir recently saw a beautiful congregation of different religious faiths at one place as it hosted the famous Sankri Fair at a village in Udhampur. Set to be organized for the last several hundred years, the three-day fair serves as a wonderful example of religious unity. Take a look.
Surrounded by meadows, lofty mountains and lush green forests lies the beautiful village Mir in the Panchari block of Udhampur. On a hillock of the village is situated a 500-year-old Sankri Devta temple. This holy place is just not famous for its scenic beauty, but also for its annual fair that is organized in its premises. Attended by thousands of devotees, irrespective of their caste and community, the three-day event is a beautiful congregation of different religious faiths. Devotees stand in long queues to pay their obeisance to the idol of the deities, who are known to be Shiva and Shakti.
बचपन से इस मेले में आ रहे हैं और इस मेले की सबसे बड़ी खासियत यह है कि यहां पे सब जाति धर्म के लोग आते हैं और यहां कोई भेदभाव नहीं है सब बड़ी श्रद्धा से माथा टेकते हैं और सच में जो गंगा जमुनी संस्कृति है भारत की ये उसका प्रतीक है सब लोग जो मिलजुल कर जहां आते हैं बाबा जी का आशीर्वाद लेते हैं और यहां जो एक्टिविटीज होती हैं डिफरेंट एक्टिविटीज 3 दिन जो होती हैं तो उनका जो है वो आनंद भी लेते हैं और दर्शन भी करते हैं
Along with seeking the blessings of the deities, the devotees also make their way to a number of makeshift stalls that are installed either by the locals or those belonging to other parts of the country. Selling sweets, toys, jewelry, and many other items, these stalls witness a huge crowd of visitors. Fun rides also make up a huge attraction at the fair, especially for the kids, who just can't wait to get into them. This year, district administration also made adequate arrangements of drinking water facility, Medicare, electricity, sanitation and transport for the visitors so as to ensure that they have a comfortable visit.
तीन चार साल हो गए अभी इधर आते हुए लगातार और इधर दंगल भी होता है मैं कुश्ती भी लड़ता हूँ इधर मुझे तो बहुत अच्छा लगता है बहुत सुहाना एक मौसम देखकर ऐसे ये पहाड़ी देखकर बहुत बहुत मजा आता है इधर आने का
The environment of the fair remains very cheerful with the beating of drums and melodious tunes of flute adding more to its charm. Over the years, the Sankari Fair has become one of the most notable events of Jammu and Kashmir that not just provide respite to the people from the daily grind, but also strengthen the thread of secularism by bringing people of different faiths at one platform.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
Prime Minister Narendra Modi recently launched a fitness movement, Fit India, in New Delhi in a bid to promote healthy living among people. Modi, who has championed the cause of a healthy India, launched the campaign on the occasion of National Sports Day. The campaign aims at encouraging people to indulge themselves in physical activities and sports, thus preventing lifestyle diseases and other deadly diseases.
Swasth vyakti, swasth parivar. और स्वस्थ समाज यही नए भारत को श्रेष्ठ भारत बनाने का रास्ता है
लाइफस्टाइल फैक्टर्स लाइक ओबेसिटी स्मोकिंग ड्रिंकिंग इनएक्टिविटी इनएडिक्वेट स्लीप एंड अ पोअर डाइट हैव लॉन्ग बीन लिंक्ड टू एन इंक्रीज्ड रिस्क ऑफ लाइफ थ्रेटनिंग डिजीजेस Thousands of devotees have thronged the Sikh shrine of Gurdwara Ramsar in Amritsar city of Punjab to mark the anniversary of installation of holy book Guru Granth Sahib in the temple. On the occasion of Prakash Parv, holy book installation ceremony, Sikh devotees carried the book in a palanquin during a religious procession inside the premises of the Golden Temple. The massive project to compile Guru Granth Sahib, which has hymns from some of the 10 Sikh Gurus, was undertaken by 5th Guru of the Sikhs, Guru Arjan Dev, at this shrine in the early 17th century.
ਅੱਜ ਦਾ ਜੋ ਨਗਰ ਕੀਰਤਨ ਹੈ ਸੱਚ ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਧੰਨ ਧੰਨ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਸ੍ਰੀ ਗ੍ਰੰਥ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਜੀ ਦੇ ਪਹਿਲੇ ਪ੍ਰਕਾਸ਼ ਪੁਰਬ ਨੂੰ ਸਮਰਪਿਤ ਜੋ ਅੱਜ ਬੇਹੱਦ ਸੰਗਤਾਂ ਵੱਲੋਂ ਬੜੇ ਉਤਸ਼ਾਹ ਤੇ ਭਾਵਨਾ ਨਾਲ ਸਜਾਇਆ ਜਾ ਰਿਹਾ
ਦਾ ਗੁਰੂ ਗ੍ਰੰਥ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਇਜ਼ ਅ ਵੋਲੂਮਿਨਸ ਟੈਕਸਟ ਵਿਦ 1430 ਪਾਰਟਸ ਦਾ ਟੈਕਸਟ ਇਜ਼ ਰਿਗਾਰਡਡ ਬਾਈ ਦਾ ਸਿਕਸ ਐਜ਼ ਦਾ ਲਿਵਿੰਗ ਇੰਬੋਡੀਮੈਂਟ ਆਫ ਦੇ 10 ਲੀਡਰਸ ਐਂਡ ਦਾ ਟੈਕਸਟ ਇਜ਼ ਪਾਇਵਟਲ ਇਨ ਵਰਸ਼ਿਪ ਇਨ ਸਿਕਿਜ਼ਮ The Indian Air Force recently inducted 8 Apache AH-64E attack helicopters at a ceremony at Pathankot Air Base. This was the first set of the intended 22 helicopters to be used by the Indian Air Force under a multi-billion dollar contract signed in 2015 with the US government and Boeing. The aircraft was inducted in a ceremony traditionally in the presence of Indian Air Force Chief, Air Chief Marshal Virendra Singh Dhanoi, President of Boeing India, Salil Gupte and other officials.
Today, with the induction of the Apache 864E, the IAF has upgraded its inventory to the latest generation of attack helicopters. Like it was covered by the CNC, we signed the contract in September 2015 to deliver 22 Apache helicopters, and these helicopters have been modified specifically to suit the exacting standards demanded by the IAF.
This latest induction is to replace the aging Mi-35. It is an advanced multi-mission helicopter with air-to-air missile capability, known to be one of the fiercest in the world, that is being operated worldwide by the defense forces of the US, UK, Israel, etc. It has the capability to shoot, fire and forget an advanced range of anti-tank guided missiles, rockets and other ammunition. It is also capable of a wide range of mission, from escort to other heli-borne operations, separation of enemy air defense, battlefield air strike roles, among others.
Japanese companies have continuously been coming up with their cutting-edge technologies, which are not just bringing development to their own country, but for other countries as well. NEC Corporation is one among these Japanese companies that is developing technology for safer cities. Recently, it also sponsored an event in Singapore in which Safe Cities Index report was released. Furukawa Electric, on the other side, is contributing to Tokyo 2020 Olympic Games with its styrofoam polyethylene technology. A report.
As the world's cities continue to expand in size and number, it struck a balance between connectivity, safety and privacy. It is vital for governments, the private sector and citizens. Cities continue to be productive and urbanization across many Asian countries has been a key factor behind their economic growth. At Raffles Hotel in Singapore, policymakers, business leaders and industry experts participated in Safe Cities Summit held by The Economist. At the event, the Safe Cities Index report was released. It ranks the world's safest cities based on indicators such as digital, infrastructure, health and personal security. The research report and event were sponsored by NEC Corporation, which is developing technology for safer cities.
This event organized by The Economist, it's a good opportunity for NEC to hear many of the opinions from policymakers and end users. And based upon those input, we'd like to reflect our strategy, what kind of business is actually contributing for the society and community. Many issues are going around regarding public safety. One of the most key components is sustainability and the safety itself. So based upon technologies of NEC, including computing, AI or networking, we strongly believe that we can contribute to the society and the community in Asia Pacific.
The Safe Cities Index rankings had 6 of the top 10 cities from the Asia-Pacific region, with Tokyo and Singapore at number 1 and number 2 respectively. Discussions at the Safe Cities Summit range from climate resilience, urban living, protection against cyber attack and police enforcement.
Well, the panel discussion was very exciting. It was talking about the long arm of the law or law enforcement agency in creating, generating safer cities. And of course, the discussion was a fair mix of technology and other elements that will make a city safer. So being a technologist, obviously we are looking at technology as a tool to make cities safer. And I was advocating the fact that one of the key critical elements to make safer city is a secure digital identity for every one of us in both the cyber and physical space.
During breaks, participants of the summit saw the latest developing technology in biometrics and surveillance. Cities all over the world should keep strengthening the security for the safety of the society. Next, we take you to the Citizen Hall in Tokyo's Hino City, where karate players are indulged in strenuous training. The national karate team members of Eastern Europe, Ukraine, are being trained in the line of the Japanese government's initiative of Host Town, aims to connect teams across the country for the preparation of Tokyo Olympics. It allows training and handling daily life situations to the team that will be participating in the marquee event. Hino City and Ukraine have signed an MOU of the host town to accept karate team. Hino City expects to accelerate international exchange and boost regional participation.
Hino Cityが大変な熱意と万全の準備をしてウクライナの選手団を迎えられると いうことを私ども存じておりましたし、そしてウクライナ選手団というのは世界空手連盟200に近い
Training is undertaken in the public gymnasium. It is necessary for the players to practice in the same conditions as is provided in the world competitions.
国が進めるホストタウン構想に基づいたもので、私どもは今年の 6月28日にウクライナを相手国としたホストタウン、そして競技としては空手競技のチームを支援することを決めました。いい成績を残せてもらえるように環境を整えて、
For the karate players, the mat on the floor is the most important and it goes by the name tatami. It provides suitability and strength required for the game. Tatami is produced by Furukawa Electric. Termed pro game, Furukawa Electric uses styrofoam polythene technology to produce this product.
適度な空手に適したですね、滑り具合、それからグリップ力を持った畳になっておりまして、表面はですね、畳のグリップをつけるために、実際の畳のいぐさのデザインの模様がついております。プロゲームは世界空手連盟の認定を取った商品でございますので、これを通じて世界の空手の普及に貢献してまいりたいと思います。
In Tokyo Olympics Japanese traditional sports, karate is added in the list of official games. Japanese cutting-edge technology supports its prosperity.
The festivals in India do not just offer a temporary reprieve from the daily grind, but also serve as a medium to bridge the gap between different communities. Presently, as the whole country is busy observing Ganesh Chaturthi and Muharram, the religious harmony is at its peak. At many places, the Ganesh Pandals and the Sabils have also been set up close to each other to spread the message of peace and harmony. Take a look.
At one side,
where the devotees are doing the ritualistic aarti of Lord Ganesha. On the other side, people can be seen quenching their thirst at the sabil. Sabil is a small cubicle that serves water, food and milk to the people during the first 10 days of Muharram, which is the first month of Islamic calendar. Both these Ganesh Pandal and the sabil have been set up adjacent to each other in the Rajkot city of Gujarat. The visitors who pass by first take the blessings of Lord Ganesha and then move forward to sabil to have the refreshing drinks, in a way paying their regards to two different faiths at the same time.
पूरे हिंदुस्तान के अंदर हिंदू मुस्लिम एकता होना चाहिए, देश के लिए कोई गद्दारी न होना चाहिए और हमारे इस्लाम धर्म के अंदर लिखा हुआ है कि जो देश के अंदर रहो वो देश का वफादार बन के रहो, इसलिए ये हिंदू मुस्लिम एकता से ये गणपति हम यहाँ बिठाते हैं और बाद में हमारा वहाँ सभी ले और ये लोग हमारे साथ में मिलजुल के रह रहे हैं, बचपन के भाई बहन दोस्त रहे और ये सभी हम 40 साल से बना रहे हैं लेकिन हमको कोई प्रॉब्लम हुआ नहीं है। वो कहना चाहता हूँ कि ऐसा भाईचारा सबके लिए रखो, चाहे कोई गणपति का उत्सव हो, चाहे मोहर्रम हो या कोई भी त्यौहार हो, हिंदू मुस्लिम साथ में रह के ये त्यौहार करो।
The Hindu and Muslim community of Rajkot have been carrying forward this tradition for the last 6 years. As Ganesh Chaturthi and the month of Muharram almost coincide with each other, both the communities have been showing immense support to one other for the successful conduct, setting a beautiful example of religious unification.
लास्ट में 5-6 साल से छबिल और गणपति जी का पंडाल साथ में हम कौमी एकता का प्रतीक है वो साथ में हम मुस्लिम बिरादरियों भाई के साथ करते हैं। हम पहले यहाँ गणपति जी का प्रसाद बांटते हैं और बाद में आरती के बाद सब भाई लोग है वो छबिल में प्रसाद लेते हैं, जो शरबत और पानी है वो लास्ट 5-6 साल से हम एक साथ काम कर रहे हैं, जो मुस्लिम बिरादरियों के भाई है और हम है साथ में एकता का प्रतीक लेके हम यहाँ पे पंडाल और छबिल लेके यहाँ पे रहते हैं।
Such examples showcasing India's secular nature can be witnessed every now and then in our country. But it's during the occasions when this beautiful bond of friendship among all faiths get much more strengthened.
The fascinating land of Odisha, known for its glorious traditions of dance and music, never fails to leave its visitors awestruck with its enamoring fiestas. Ranging from Puri's Rath Yatra to Bhubaneswar's temple festivals, the state has much more in its abode that reflects the vibrant lifestyle of its people. The 3-day classical dance and music program, celebrated thrice in a year, is one among these occasions and was recently observed in Bhubaneswar. With an objective to promote traditional art forms of Odisha, the 41st edition of Barsha Dance and Music Festival was recently celebrated at Bhubaneswar's Rabindra Mandap. Organized by Chinta Uchetna, a socio-cultural organization that was established in 1980, this 3-day event was inaugurated by Minister of Higher Education and Agriculture, Odisha, Dr. Arun Kumar Sahu, the chief guest of the occasion. Celebrated thrice every year by the name of Varsha, Vasant and Baisakhi, this event has been a testament to beautiful musical and dance representations by renowned artists from across the country.
यहाँ पर वर्षा के ऊपर ढेर सारे कार्यक्रम हुआ है, संगीत, नृत्य और मैजिक शो भी हुआ है और वर्षा के ऋतु पर जो ख्याल गायन और जो बंदिश, ये सब कुछ पिछले साल भी हुआ था, इस साल भी होने वाला है और इसमें ढेर सारे प्रतिभा को देश भर में चुन चुन करके इसमें फेलिसिटेट किया जाता है ताकि वो आगे बढ़े सो क्षेत्र में और इस मंच पर भिजी जोग बिस्मिल्ला खां से लेकर के हेमा मालिनी से लेकर के आपका उषा उत्थप से लेकर के और इंटरनेशनली रिप्यूटेड जितने आर्टिस्ट हैं और सुनंदा पटनायक से लेकर के गिरिजा देवी से लेकर के सब कोई वर्षा पर प्रोग्राम किए हैं।
The traditional dance performances, accompanied with the melodious beats of classical Odissi music, created a magical environment during the event. A variety of dance and musical performances were given by various national and international dance groups, among them special dance performances dedicated to Lord Shiva and Lord Krishna were the major attractions that left the audience spellbound.
प्रथम प्रस्तुति में था हमारा भो शंभु जो शिव भगवान शिव के ऊपर था उनकी वंदना एक है भो शंभु जो दयानंद सरस्वती जी ने कंपोज किया है म्यूजिक कंपोजिशन और कोरियोग्राफी हमारे गुरु श्री रतिकांत महापात्र जी ने किया है दूसरी प्रस्तुति में हमने किया था समकाला समकाला एक प्योर डांस है इट्स लाइक अ पल्लवी बट इट शोज वेरियस स्टेप्स एंड इनोवेटिव कोरियोग्राफीज एंड देन द थर्ड प्रस्तुति वॉज विठ्ठल स्मरणे है कृष्ण वंदना
आर्टिस्ट ऑल्सो ग्रेस द स्टेज विद द इंट्रोलिंग पाइका डांस ऑफ ओडिशा that showcased the role of freedom fighters during the freedom struggle of India.
हम लोग यहाँ पे आज पाइका डांस परफॉर्म करने वाले हैं जो कि उड़ीसा में हम आज़ादी के समय पे पाइका ने क्या सब कंट्रीब्यूशन दिया है वो हम लोग दिखाने वाले हैं
Varsha festival is the great depiction of rainy season through dance and music. At the time when somehow youngsters are losing their cultural identification due to the advancement in technology and globalization, these kinds of festivals are helping them in staying connected to their roots.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at suggest.myindia@gmail.com. I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay and it's goodbye from the entire production team.